to my channel. Hi guys, my name is Thea Dolmasu. If you are new here, welcome to the second update of my pregnancy. So this will be the second trimester update. And if you're returning, thank you very much for returning. I love you loads, guys. Guys, so I'm currently on my, today actually, I'm starting my 8th month of pregnancy. So this means I'm already on my 3rd trimester. And yeah, I tried recording, actually not those I tried. So I was supposed to record for you guys on the last day of my 2nd trimester, but I got really sick. Like I had terrible flu. And kumba pants. And yeah, so I couldn't shoot. So I was just like, so a week later, I was like, let me just finish this month, and then I'll do a little bit of my 3rd trimester as well, because I think now my 3rd trimester is gonna be a little busy, and chances are I won't be able to do a 3rd trimester update if things go according to how I think they would. Chances are I'll just give you guys a birth story and whatsoever, because honestly, I'd be lying if I say my pregnancy is giving me problems. So there's really not much to tell. And yeah, guys, I think I'm starting to look pregnant now. Sega kombisa, because my nose is like, girl, I'm here. So I don't know where I left off on my first updates, because I haven't edited that yet. If you guys see this video, chances are I've already given birth, because Konama Kwehi and my mom was like, post when the baby is here. So that's why I have not been vlogging. A lot of people are asking me, why aren't you vlogging? And most of them be my clients. So my clients, people basically know that I'm pregnant. They can see it's obvious. But you know, some people will be like, you're jinxing it, posting it on social media. So I'm trying as hard as possible to keep it away from social media, but I went to wear papa. That's what the way. So I posted this little thingy here, boomerang. I was wearing this jumpsuit, and yeah, so I posted me thinking with snowman. It's not I bonagal gangago, even if bonagara. I did not say I'm pregnant. So guys, people were sending congratulations and stuff. I'm like, hi bo. So I ended up showing my mom like, yeah, you're near Bonagala, Maui, Zumi. So I'm like, I'm on both social media, by papa, guys. What if I have fibroids? What if I have an illness that's making my tummy grow? And I had to address the issue. Mina, I posted on my stories. So guys, how do you congratulate someone who hasn't said anything about something? And then others apologized, and then others was like, kept it moving. So me, my guys, personally, I've learned not to ask a person about you're pregnant, because what if that person just lost a baby like last week or something, and then you're triggering them? Don't say congratulations until someone says they're pregnant, even if don't do it. And there's a client of mine who had lost a baby early in her pregnancy. She told me about this, I didn't know. And then later on, I could see, man, because she started wearing baggy clothes. I could see that. But I never asked why, because she had told me before about she had a miscarriage earlier on before. And if she did not tell me, that means she's not comfortable talking about it. And then she only told me later when she had the baby, and it was like, by the way, I had a baby. I'm like, I could tell. And she was like, why didn't she say anything? And I was like, because you did not say nothing. So I don't want to offend her. Oh, but let's see, you look pregnant, and you know, the same thing happened again. So you guys need to have manners. If someone has not said, oh, but they are pregnant, please don't say nothing. They could have gained weight, something could have happened. Just be sensitive about this issue. Anyway, I didn't have a problem because really I'm pregnant. But if I did not say nothing to you, keep it quiet, Sebo. Okay, so I'm rambling. Like, I have a lot to say. Okay, like I said, I don't know where I left off from my last video, from my first trimester video. after. By the way, so my first trimester, I lost my sense of smell, so I couldn't smell anything. Up until, I think about a month or so ago, in the middle of my second trimester, my smell came back. So now I can smell everything. I thought it had to do with my work, like the dust and the products that I'm using. Because I have completely lost my sense of smell. But I think it had to do with my pregnancy. So those were one of the symptoms. And then the growing pains. They don't tell us about round ligament pains, guys. So round ligament pains is when your uterus is growing, like it's expanding to make room for the baby. Those were uncomfortable. They were uncomfortable, I don't wanna lie. And then what else did I come across? Nothing, honestly. I've never craved weird things so far. I just crave normal stuff, but it's not that deep. But if I need to langa, it's nothing to cry about. And also, I don't know if I mentioned, but we did go bigger isisu. Guys, my baby daddy. So my baby daddy issues, I think I'm gonna have baby daddy issues. I don't know. But yeah, guningi, and it gets guningier. So you guys, I have told you, my baby is from a sneaky link. So we had a meeting, so we're not on speaking terms because of his decisions. And I'm not that childish to not speak to people. Like, why? So yeah, I had a meeting and then things were solved. Even in the meeting, I did say, but I don't want this guy. I don't want to be in a relationship with him. I just want us to discuss how we're gonna co-parent, go about co-parenting and so on and so forth. Hike. After that, umfana wangtita gane, and then he was like, no, I want us to raise our child together, yada yada yada. I'm not gonna talk too much because I know the stalker is watching my video and I know the stalker is gonna be happy about this. Boo, I don't care, whatever makes y'all happy, I don't care, yeah, bro? So I'm like, yeah. And he was like, no, I want us to raise our child. Gunguti, earlier on in our relationship, when he was asking me for a baby, he was like, this is what he wants for himself. He wants to have a home, come back to his wife and kids, you know? So he said that again. I was like, oh, okay, let's just give it a try for the sake of one, yeah, bro? Guys, it was different. You know, when you're sneaky leaking with someone, you don't spend a lot of time with them. And then when you're in a relationship, you get to learn the person. So I was like, I'm not sure about this. Are you really my type? I felt like we're not compatible. Like, it was just too much for me. But I was like, let me just relax. I lang relax a corner. Umbalanzi, you 10. Which was expected, I don't want to lie, I don't care, Fruity. But what made me upset is I didn't expect him to ghost me, basically, you know? Because mdala. And I think what upsets me the most with his behavior is because he's 10 years older than me. And I'm like, dude, I expected a lot from you. I don't care if we're not in a relationship, but I expect you to be there for me. So yeah, he was just there for a few weeks and then nothing. But I'm glad to say that I have, why am I Ubering and getting closer? I'm not closer. I'm happy to say that I have support, hey? I'm surrounded by very supportive people. I'd be lying, mangati, I cried a lot in my pregnancy. Out of 100%, I probably cried like 5% of it. And then I was like, you know what? God knew that I wanted this child and he knew when it will happen. And things are aligning and it's not that deep. Whether daddy's there or not, I know my child will have a beautiful life. Because this is God's plan, yeah, bro? I'm happy, guys. I'm okay. Am I enjoying my pregnancy? I don't know. I don't know what to say. What's there to enjoy? Like, it's just me with a growing belly, being uncomfortable here and there. There's nothing really much to enjoy. And most of it's in winter, so thank God I'm always indoors. I don't have to dress up. That's another story, dressing up. Oh, but I didn't buy maternity stuff, so my mom gave me some of her things to wear. And then I only got this jumpsuit. I'll show you guys at the end of the video. I got this jumpsuit and one dress from Shein. And then if I'm home, I'm always in pajamas or my track pants or something. And then when I go to work, that's where the struggle is. But this is my lifesaver. No matter what I'm getting, it's mine. I bought it and it's comfortable. Okay, back to my support system, guys. So I'll start with my mom. Obviously, my mom is so over the moon. She's happy about my pregnancy. So she would make sure that I'm okay on my emotional days, which were not much. She's just there and she tries very hard for me to not go away. And yeah, my mom and ubamkhulu wenganyam, guys. Ubamkhulu wenganyam. So my baby daddy's big brother, Shane, he's there for me. I don't want to lie. He's pretty much doing what the daddy is supposed to be doing. So I'm also grateful for him and my friends. And my friends, obviously, they are planning my baby shower together with my cousin. And yeah, all of them, my friends and my cousin, I have no words. I have no words. Those girls have been there for me since day one. Really, they know the struggles and everything. They're there to listen to my stories and stuff. And also, yes, I know about my baby shower. So it's my friends, my cousin, my mnane. And now, guys, there's a client of mine who insisted. That's how much. I wish I could tell you guys my baby's name now, but it means good things are coming, yeah, bro? And I'm feeling the love. It's so overwhelming. The client was like, I insist, I want to be part of your baby shower. I want to contribute whatever they need. I'll pop up my name. So I had to add her. So in this journey, I'm learning Uguzi. She even once said Uguzi, abafwin uzobathola ngendlela, meaning that you can create family along the way. So family is not always blood, you understand? So I feel like she's gonna be a very close friend because the efforts she's putting, like, I don't know, guys, like, I feel like it's so overwhelming. And she keeps on telling me that you are very lovable. Yeah, lovable, so allow us to do this for you. So she entered the group and then they're planning it. I know of it because my mom, she does deco, and she was like, she wanted to involve me because I'm a very picky person. And I was like, no, I don't want to know the gory details. Just tell me the day and what to wear, because I don't want to be surprised with an ugly dress. I don't want to be surprised with an ugly makeup. And also, I like need to take a day off. So I want to make sure that I look pretty at least. And then the rest of the details, I don't want to know. But yeah. You will know some of the things they will tell me and stuff, but I'm not in the group. And yes, the stories here and there, I hear them. Am I excited? I am excited, but the little thing that frustrates me, I feel like the date that they chose is a little close to my due date, meaning I can't buy much now until I get to see what I get from the baby shower, you understand? But I have started buying, and guys, we need to backtrack. So after the meeting, yeah, and the baby daddy and I being okay, later on we went for, so I started my antenatal visits. I am currently going to Unjani Clinic. It's a private clinic. I chose Unjani Clinic because, guys, I don't see myself queuing in my linini or say public clinics. I don't have medical aid, so I am paying every month for my antenatal visits. So yeah, I'm spending a lot of money, and it's winter, business is slow, so you guys can imagine them go. I'm going through financially, but God is seeing me through. I don't want to lie, I don't know Gajani, but I never missed an appointment. Everything that I need, I get. Yeah, but anyway, by me, no one has given me money, guys. No one has given me money. But I'm happy. So also went to the doctor to find out my baby's gender. And this is how it went, you guys. This is how it went.
This is the baby's face. Open the eyes, the nose, and the mouth is there. Let me see if I can do better.
that he'll also find out the gender today.
Yeah, tell you the gender just now.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the face looking sideways.
Okay.
Okay, there's the one arm and the hand is there. Okay, the other arm is there. Okay.
Okay, can we see the legs as well?
Yeah, I'm going to show you now. We're going from top to bottom. There's the heart. Okay, that's normal.
Alright.
That's the abdomen. Okay.
Okay.
And the stomach. Okay. And the legs are here. So we're looking between the legs for gender.
It's a girl.
Okay, it's a baby girl.
You see them?
Yeah, you're right about that. Okay, so it's a baby girl. Yeah, unformed. You can see it nicely.
Yeah.
And there's the legs and there's the foot. There's the foot there. It's a bit blurry because the baby was moving, but there's the foot. There's the toes. Okay.
Okay. This is a no girl. No girl, girl.
I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that.
Can you recommend the level of the level of the level of
the
level of the level of the
level
of the level of the level of the
level.
Season and Tombazana.
Oh,
so
yeah, we were happy. I'm having a girl. I'm having a girl and I'm happy. Oopsie, I'm gonna have my little bro bestie. I don't know, like I really wanted a girl. I don't know if I had a boy. I mean, guys, nah, I'm a girly girl and I think it's gonna be easier for me if I'm a girl mom. So God knew what he was doing. And yeah, so after that, my mom and I went shopping. I wanted to, so Dis-Chem has this thingy of, but if you buy more than 1,000 rands and apply for the parenting program or something like that, you get a bag for when you go to deliver. I think you get the bag from 34 to 36 weeks of your pregnancy if you spend more than a grand on newborn stuff and baby things from Baby City or Dis-Chem. So that's what we went to go do, and we bought a little, some few stuff, and then also we went to Ackermans. My mom was like, I want to lay by my girl some stuff for when she leaves the hospital. So my mom bought us some cute things, which I'll show you guys later on. And yeah, that was it. Everyone's happy, we're all excited. And yeah, so with the support system, also my good friend Tabang is a guy. He takes care of me, Vanta. He takes care of me, and he's also expecting a baby. So he's like, I'm gonna have twins. So he's expecting his child 3 weeks before me. So basically, our kids will grow up together. And he makes, if I'm craving something, he's just a call away. So yeah, thanks to him as well, Shane Vanta. Yo, I can't say thank you enough. Like, such kindness that I received from this pregnancy journey is very beautiful. Also, as I said, it's winter and business is slow. I don't have money for, you know, all those pretty little things because I need to get ready for baby. So one of my clients again insisted on paying for my photo shoot. She was like, no man, you're a content creator, we want you to deliver content. I'm like, guys, content sometimes is money. And she's like, no, just get hair, get a dress, and then tell me, and then we'll sort it out. So she and the client that insisted on being part of my baby shower planning also said the same thing. And then I tell her about the other one, and then she's like, no, let me talk to her and then maybe we can split the money because I feel like it's too much. And the client that I'm talking about is the one that just had a baby and she didn't do such things for herself. And I'm like, it's too much, I can't expect her to pop out that money just for me to take photos. And then this one is like, don't worry, I'll talk to her, let's go 50-50, you get your dress, get your makeup done, get your hair, and then get your photo shoot, honey. I'm like, who needs a baby daddy? Who needs a baby daddy when you're surrounded by such lovely people? So yeah, I'm very thankful for that. I'm very thankful, I'm grateful. Like, yonkinte ihamba kahle, guys. Yonkinte ihamba kahle. And I don't know what to say anymore. I wish I wrote things down, but anyway, there's nothing much. So I'm as shining as my belly. So this is how we are currently looking. I'm going to go back. So today I'm starting my month 8. So that means I'm currently 38 weeks. And this is our belly. And the jumpsuit is from Shein. Very, very comfortable. Love it, get sana. And yeah, the little bits of my, the first month, the first 4 weeks of my, third trimester. Couldn't lie, I was starting to feel pregnant now. I was like, Kaibo, can this baby get out of me already? I was Googling, I was on TikTok. So guys, another thing, TikTok helped me. If it wasn't for TikTok, I swear. You know, I don't like hearing, when you're going through something and then umuntu atsi, you're not the first one to go through. I don't want to hear that. Even if I'm not the first one and I know I'm not the first or last one. You understand? But it was soothing to see a community of women, you know, going through what you are going through, and you're able to publicly talk about it. So if it wasn't for TikTok as well, guys, maybe so when I speak to one of my clients and then I tell her my story and she's like, hi, maybe I'm shanyela, and like, I'm like, for what? And then what am I gonna gain for it? Guys, if someone shows you, this is how they feel about you or wants things done, just let them be and keep it moving. Because I'm from the high blood. I don't want to stress my baby and stuff. So yeah, I will search on TikTok or we'll see how does a baby born in 30 weeks look like every time. Only to find out, my baby was turning. Cause I think my pregnancy is literally a textbook kind of pregnancy. All the notifications and symptoms that I'm getting are things that are happening to me. So there was a time, I guess when I started feeling pregnant was when my baby was turning, cause a day or two later, the symptoms that I had and what was happening, they were like, your baby's most likely turning now. And so also that was very uncomfortable for like 2 days. It was uncomfortable. I don't know if they should call them Braxton Hicks, if that's what I was experiencing, but yeah, it was kind of painful. But yeah, we are back to being normal. I have back pains here and there if I'm working for a long time and or standing, so it's normal. There's nothing we can do, but yeah, it's not that deep. Am I looking forward to giving birth? Do I have a birth plan? I don't have a birth plan. I mean, guys, I'm told you to meet at a public hospital. So apparently public hospital, it's always natural birth unless you have an emergency. I think you can't choose like Guma private hospitals where you can just have a date planned and ask for a C-section. So yeah, whatever, because I don't have experience of both when I'm pushing or when they're cutting me. I just want to see my baby girl already. I'm excited for that. So yeah, let's not make the video long. Let's do a little unboxing of the things that I've already bought so far. So the first thing I bought, I was buying my brother sneakers. He asked me to buy him Air Force, and I'm like, you know, my child, I can't buy you something and I'll get my girl something. So this is the first thing I bought to my girl to get her number sneakers. Got my little kiss. I got her these little tiny sneakers. So I don't know about the sizes and baby sizes and stuff, but I think this was the smallest size. I don't know if it was a Koga Magapuma or a month later or whatever. I have no idea. So yeah, I got her these little cute sneakers. So my brother's like, okay, these people grow so fast, Debo. So my brother's like, one of them, is being on my car. I'm like, that's so ghetto. I'm gonna keep them for my second child. Guys, I don't want a child. I don't want one child. I'll see how parenting goes, because pregnancy wasn't that deep. If my parenting goes smoothly, definitely having a second child. I don't like I'm my only child. So yeah, that's the first thing we got. And then we first went to Baby City. Okay, so Baby City, we got Anga Pampers. So they were on special. We got Pampers. They were on special. Guys, I'm not gonna tell you the price. It's not important. Not everyone here is pregnant, and by the time you see this special, it's gonna be pretty anyway. Okay, so we got two of these. So my mom was like, yeah, now she hasn't had a baby in a long time, so I guess, yeah, well, I think, I don't remember if number one, they didn't have number one or it wasn't on special, but we got two of number twos. Either way, we are piling up, we are stocking up so that, sorry, I'm not gonna have to be stressed when baby arrives. You can never have enough nappies, you can never have enough wipes. So eventually these will be used. It may not be soon, but eventually they will be used. And if you guys didn't know, Dis-Chem and Clicks, as long as you the nappies are not open, they do take them back, whether you have a receipt or not. They will take them back should maybe baby is not taking the products well, or God forbid, maybe baby doesn't make it and you have a whole lot of baby stuff. So we got this, two of them. And then so these are the things we got. They were 1,200 rands, and the lady at the till says how it works is they will email me later on and tell me if all of the things that I bought here qualify for the bag, for the Dis-Chem bag with newborn stuff. And it's a hospital bag. So you get some goodies there that are gonna be for you and baby. So what we got Pampers. So it's six times, six packets in here. Guys, I need to pee. come again, you will go to the toilet 1,000 times. And then we got this 0 to 3 months. We got a vest and the quality looks good. That's the reason I took this, because the quality looks good. And I see the mummies on TikTok are saying Ackerman's vest are not the one. Apparently they stretch here by the chest. And my mom loved this and she was like, Andy, yay. So this is a vest. Because I don't know baby terminology and the clothes. But as if you crawl or yinile. But it's proudly South African. And it's written in Ndlovukazi. So it's gonna be in Ndlovukazi Gogo. Ndlovukazi means what does it mean? What does Ndlovukazi mean? I don't know, queen or something. But yeah, it's this cute little thingy for baby. We got Vaseline. So I was like, let's start with non-scented one, the original one, because we don't know if she's gonna be sensitive or not, because yeah, my skin can be sensitive, guys, and I'm already starting to have pimples, like baby rash sort of pregnancy thingy, and it's annoying me and my homegirls, because some skincare products you can't use while you're pregnant. And then we got this combo. So these are her toiletries. So it's Epimax body wash. We got a body wash. We got a bar soap. It's a bar soap, a glycerin bar, yeah. And then this is bum barrier cream. So we're gonna start her with these and see, hopefully she's not gonna react to them. So it was buy one, get, you know, the discount thingy. It was buy two and get one free. And then we got Surgical Spirit. And then we got baby oil. So yeah, those things were like 1.2. Guys, what about Dura? Don't let people tell you what's uso cooler or what. And kids are expensive. I can already feel it. So everything that I am spending on my pregnancy and baby so far has amounted to almost 7 grand. I'm writing it down and keeping the receipts. Okay, no, you know. For in case someone decides to come back and be like, yeah, yeah, I'm done. Guys, I'm fine. I forgot to tell you, because we are not on speaking terms, but I hear on the streets of my head. Okay, I did see the excitement as well. So before, we are not talking together, not talking to each other. His brother told me, he's happy and excited and what so and so on and so forth. And then when we spoke, started speaking, I saw the excitement. He's happy. And then now that we're not talking anymore, I hear him on the streets that he tells people who see that he's a father to be. Jan, how are you a father to be? Estrateni pela. So my mom was like, write everything down, keep receipts. Should he wants to claim, you can't run away when I'm pregnant and then come back and claim. We want our shares from the money spent here. Yeah? So that's what I'm doing. So when I stalk, if you're watching, boom, chill. Okay, and then remember we went to go lay by stuff from Ackerman's. So these costed around 600 rands. The total was around 600 rands. So my favorite. So we got this, it's a five piece set. So it's just, guys, I don't know if it's a romba or it's a onesie or it's a jumpsuit. I don't know, but this is what baby girl is gonna come out of hospital with. So this little thingy. And then it comes with a bib that says, I can change the world. She definitely will. I know she will be a smart little girl. But see, you must speak life into your children. And I know my girl is gonna be smart and she will change the world. And then it has this vest thingy. It says the same thing, I will change the world. And then name these pants. So yeah, this is our leaving the hospital outfits. So I needed to show you guys. I think I'm gonna wash them. I don't know. For people who had babies, did you guys wash your baby clothes when you went to hospital? Because I feel like everyone is touching them and stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna wash these when I pack my hospital bag and then put them in there. And then Ogogo also got us this 4-pack vest, long sleeved body vest. So it's this shade of pink and a white one from Ackerman. So I guess this will be my first and last purchase of this vest from Ackerman's, because I see a lot of ladies complaining now. And then we got these. Now I'm a crawl or whatever they are. A 3-piece. They are so cute. So there's this pink bunny one and this polka dots gray one, as well as this cream one with buttons and a bunny. So these are very cute. I love these clothes so much, and thank you to my mama. So yeah, we got new size newborn. So I had to return these. This is not big. We got tiny. Apparently they are tiny newborns and a newborn. So it had kgs. It has kgs written here, right? So we got, I think it was less than 1.7 kgs. So these ones say 1.8 kgs to 4 kgs, because my baby is growing at a normal rate, so I doubt so would say she'll be less than 2 kg. So I have to return these and take them back. What else did we get? Okay, so these go with these, but you buy them separately. So we also got, these heads, which I feel like they're small, guys. So when I go to Isona, guys, my baby has a big head. That one is stressing me. There's a time even the nurse is laughing at my baby saying she has a big head. Guys, I'm a man. And then we got these 2 pairs of white socks. That was it. It's around 600 rands at Ackerman's. And then later on, my mom was like, Nimoni special a box. They had nappies. So they had these for two. I don't remember the price. I think it was 250. And then she got number two. She says the newborns were not on special, or they were out of stock, something like that. So she got that. So the reason we bought different brands is to see which one she'll take. Hopefully she's not allergic to any of the brands, and then isn't pasagashi anything. So yeah, we got this. So because we got 2 size 2s, I just decided to start buying size 1s, and then for when to start picking my hospital bag and for when she arrives. So I did get a packet of size 1. It was on special as well, Clicks. So I need to buy another, and I'm gonna buy another one from Huggies, size 1 from Huggies, and then see which one is gonna be good for her. And then I hope she's not picky, because returning these things will be a problem. So yeah, I'm on my stocking journey. I don't want stress for when baby's here. I don't want to run out of anything. So yeah, guys, that's a lot of talking from me. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're going to be a new mom, please comment down below and tell us about your journey and how's it going, and are you nervous with giving birth? Also, I mean, I don't mind hearing birth stories. I always ask my clients who have kids, but how did it go? So yeah, if you're a mom, any advice, please comment down below. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm gonna be walking this new life with me, guys. I'm gonna be producing a lot of mommy content from now on. Yeah, my life is about to change, and I'm nervous and excited at the same time. So yeah, Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. I don't know if it's gonna be a vlog or another update, but yeah, thank you for watching. Bye.